Hi everyone, welcome back to 4D Dig. After giving Mako Sequoia Beta a try on your Mac, you may realize it's not right for you. So, in today's video, we will show you how to revert to Mako Sonoma. Let's jump in. Create a backup with Time Machine is a necessary step before installing Mako Sequoia. We should note that downgrading MacOS involves erasing current installation, so make sure the external storage that contains recent backup is connected correctly. If you don't have a backup, you can use 4DDig McData Recovery to scan for lost files. Now let's proceed to downgrade MacOS. First, get Mako Sonoma from App Store. Download Mako Sonoma. You will find it cannot be downgraded directly. So we need to create a Mako Sonoma bootable media. Insert a USB. Go to Launchpad and open Disk Utility. Select the USB flash drive and erase it to macOS Extended Journal format. Then open Terminal. Type the command sudo space. Then open Finder and go to Application. Locate Install Mako Sonoma. Right-click it and select Show Package Contents. Double-click Contents and open Resources folder. Find Create Install Media Executable file. Drag it over to Terminal. Then type dash dash volume space. Go to Finder. Go up and click Go. Select Go to Folder. Type slash volumes. You will see the USB here. Drag it to Terminal. Press Enter key. It will ask for your password to create the bootable USB installer. Put it in. Wait for a while, you will get a bootable disk. Shut down. Hold the power button on Apple Silicon Mac until the startup options appear. Choose Install Mako Sonoma and click Continue. Thank you. you will get the message that the volume cannot be downgraded. Then we need to go to Disk Utility to erase the installation. Go up and quit install macOS. Click Disk Utility. Select your system volume. Erase it. And your Mac will restart. Hold power button to enter recovery mode. Now you can choose anyone and activate your Mac. Reinstall macOS Sonoma. It will take some time. Once done, set up your Mac and restore data from Time Machine Backup with Migration Assistant. That's it. If you think this video is helpful, don't forget to subscribe and give us a thumbs up. Thanks for watching.